Well, glory. It's good to see y'all here today. Now, everybody's been wanting to know about my Hawaiian shirt. The Lord woke me up probably about 6 months ago and told me he was sending me to the islands. I went down to Belk's to the clearance rack and bought me 2 Hawaiian shirts. Now, what the Lord didn't or failed to tell me, it was going to be a sandbar in the middle of that Edisto River. That was going to be the island. So, anyway. Huh? That's right.
That's funny.
Stand right here. All right. I want you to pray real hard, okay? Pray. Pray. See all these people out here? Can you pray? You want to pray for me? All right, pray for
me. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to pray for everyone here, and I want to pray for everyone that's sick, and I want to pray that everyone wakes up and has a good day. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Wasn't that a beautiful prayer? I'll tell you, they raising them youngins right over Connie Maxwell. I love you. All right, I'm going to share some scripture with you and make a few remarks if I didn't lose my notes. Somewhere in here. There we go. We're talking today about baptism. Can y'all hear me all right? Are you listening? No talking while I'm talking, okay? Romans chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Now we can answer that question, right? If you've been saved by the grace of God, you're not supposed to continue to live and practice sin, right? Amen? God forbid, how shall we that are dead to sin live any longer? Know ye not that so many of us were baptized into Jesus Christ and were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. If we have been planted together, planted in the water, in the likeness of his death, the similarity of his death, we shall also be in the likeness of his resurrection. Know this, that our old man is crucified. Say that with me. The old man is dead.
Old man.
Say that again. The old man is dead.
Old man is dead.
The new man is alive. Now that didn't start with baptism, but it starts when you ask the Lord Jesus Christ to come into your heart.
Amen.
He takes an anvil and he destroys sin right there. And then you begin living and walking a new life in Jesus Christ. For he that is dead is free from sin. Now he being dead with Christ, believe that we shall also live and reign with him. There are 3 reasons for baptism. First of all, to follow the example of our Lord. He went down to the river Jordan and was baptized of John. Now John reluctantly baptized him, but you see, Jesus wanted to identify with the baptism of John and the ministry of John. Now, if we are obedient Christians, we want to identify with Jesus Christ. And so that's the reason we're baptized, because we want to follow his example. The second reason is because we are obedient children of God. I want you to understand something. If you are a born-again child of God and you have never had believer's baptism, now you might have been sprinkled when you was a baby, but that don't count. You understand that, right? Nod your head like a billy goat. If you have not had believer's baptism, you are not an obedient child of God. And if you can't get that one little thing correct, then guess what? God can't have any bigger things for you, okay? Until you manage to obey that one little thing and follow him in believer's baptism. The third reason is that we're baptized is because we identify with Jesus. He is our Lord and our Savior. And he was buried in the ground, and he rose again to live the third day. So when we go down to the water, we are going in a watery grave, dead to sin, and we are resurrected to begin a new journey living for him from that moment on to do what Christ wants us to do with our lives. Amen?
Amen.
Now, that means 3 things. First of all, it means that we are converted. Now, understand something. If you do not have an intimate relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, you cannot be baptized. There's not been a time in your life when you bowed your head as a sinner and said, Christ, I'm a hell-deserving sinner. I want you in my heart and my life. And you invited him into your heart. You are not converted, and I don't care how many times you're baptized. You can be baptized so many times all the fish know you by first name, but that ain't going to help you, okay? you're going down a wet center, or a dry center, you're coming up a wet center, unless you have been converted to the Lord Jesus Christ, okay? There's nothing magical about baptism. It has no power whatsoever. It is just a symbol and example to the world that we are following Jesus. The second thing that we need to understand from these scriptures is that we have crucified the old man. Now, he specifically says our members are dead. You learned a little song when you were a child, Oh, Be Careful. You remember that song? Well, you see, our members now belongs to Christ, okay? Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. Your hands have to bring glory to God. If they don't, then guess what? They're bringing glory to something else. Oh, be careful, little feet, where you go. Now, that's a big one, isn't it? Because our feet takes us a lot of places that the folks don't understand that we shouldn't go as children of God. And then we get to the other members of the body. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, my word. You mean to tell me that the Lord is looking down from above and watching in love, and so I have to be careful what I see? Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Your music has to glorify God. The things you see, the movies you see, has to glorify God. And then be careful, little mouth, what I speak. Maybe I should say, be careful, big mouth, what I speak. We have to practice saying things that glorify God. You understand? Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so that's the two things. Now, it also means being crucified with the Lord. Not only have we crucified our members, but we've also crucified our feelings. Now, you have to explain that to Baptists, okay? You probably don't know it, but you dear people that are being baptized into the local Baptist church today, you are joining the meanest bunch of people on the face of the earth. Baptist. There ain't nobody fights any worse than Baptist. Ain't nobody tells you off no worse than Baptist.
Amen.
So what we have to do is crucify. Who said amen? So what you have to do is crucify your feelings, because I promise you, if you're in a Baptist church for any length of time, somebody's going to hurt your feelings, okay? But you just remember what the preacher said. My feelings have been crucified. They're under the blood, so I'm going to just have to take it and grin. Amen?
Amen?
It also means that our resources are baptized. Now, what do you mean resources? I mean money. I think we ought to teach children when they're little that they're supposed to give to the glory of God. Those offering plates that are passed through the pews ain't time to pray. It's time to give, okay? And so I give my money for the glory of God. I heard of a preacher one time, Brother Larry, that baptized all of his people with the billfold in the back pocket so they know that the money belongs to God, okay? So we've crucified our feelings, we've crucified our members, and we've crucified our resources. But it also says now we have risen to live a new life in Jesus. Amen? We're coming up from the watery grave. And our journey now, we got a spring in our step that's going to end in the kingdom of God. Let me tell you something, friends. There is no greater experience in the world than all of a sudden when you ask Jesus to come into your heart, when you wake up in the morning knowing that no matter what happens to you through that day, if a gunman comes down and blows us all away, you die in a car accident or you drop dead from a heart attack. Because Jesus is in your heart, you're going to go to heaven when you die.
Amen?
Amen. What a wonderful experience. So we're risen to live a new life for Jesus, and we're living for Him. Songwriter said, living for Jesus, a life that is true, striving to please Him in all that I do. Yielding allegiance, glad-hearted and free, this is the pathway of blessing for me. You know, there's a lot of unhappy people in the world, but if they would learn the verses of that song, they'd learn what happiness is all about. It's not in things we have or possess. It's not in friendships in this world. But our walk with Jesus Christ is what creates happiness and peace and contentment in our lives. The younger we learn that, the better off we will be. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as we prepare, dear God, for baptism, I ask you, Lord, to oversee this time together, keep us all safe. And I thank you for the families and friends, Lord, that's come to be a part of this greatest time. Thank you, Lord, for the social committee and the food. Thank you for the bowling girls, Lord, and the music they have provided. And I ask you, Lord, right here today, that everyone under the sound of my voice, that we will examine our lives. If we have never asked you into our heart and our lives, we would never realize that you died on the cross to save us. I pray today, Lord, we'll open our heart and ask Jesus to come in and say, yes, I believe Jesus died for me, and today I receive him into my heart. I ask you, Lord, just to guide and direct all that we undertake to do and be honored and glorified from this moment on in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people said,
amen.
Now, if you would.
Thank you.
but I want to go.
Do you, Lily Serrano, by profession of faith and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost, I baptize thee. Buried in the likeness of Christ, risen to live a new life in Jesus. Do you, Carrie Ann Goodwin, by profession of faith and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? And in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, I baptize thee. Buried in the likeness of Christ. Have we missed anybody? Everybody? Thank you so much. God bless you. Give you all these baptism cannons one last hand.